Hello friends of software entertainment and welcome to Never Code Alone. You wanna know more about Claude Code and want to have best practice with SuperClaude for actual analyze in PHP projects? Where is the legacy hell? What you can do and how to come out of this? Then you are right here. Totally perfect. My name is Roland and I will publish two tutorials on YouTube every week. So if you do not know the channel, just follow and click the bell. Today we will have a live run here with SuperClaude in a PHP legacy importer project and we'll check what it finds, what it gets to do and how it works. Normally I make YouTube tutorials here in German, but when you want more English speaking content, then just make a like on it and comment it I will go forward with this spectacular topic. And now let's dive into the metrics right after the intro. So first of all, let me give you a quick overview about the project. This is a Sulu CMS project. Sulu CMS is a full stack Symfony content management system. You can use your Symfony projects like they are and give them a lot of content management features. And on this page, there is an import from cars from mobile.de. And this is super hard what happens here. When you see a car, you have a car and this car here has now different kind of images and here some specifications and a lot of data from the specific details and so on and a price and kilometers and whatever you need for it. So let's see what happened here. Here's an article import command, and this article import command has a lot of legacy code, is not tested, and have a lot of problems. The main problem was that they told me that mobile.de has a clean API, but there is no API, there is a CSV download. And this download makes a lot of problems. The first thing that I have to do is to download the articles and I want to have also some debug features for my local command that I can say, hey, only import 3 cars or 5 cars or even less cars than on the last import to check if cars are deleted when they are not in the actually data, because you don't have any chance to know what cars are new and what cars are old. You just get all cars from this kind of data API. So I set here some things and then I make this CSV download and have here this import articles. After this import articles, I make a lot of counts and I give it back here to the terminal to see what happened. This is the main body of this command and you see here that this command is not only a command, so it's also getting data from CSVs. This is legacy because there are too much things doing on places where you don't think that they were done. Like this CSV thing here in this article import command. And then you have a CSV download handler and so on and so on. And we just can take a little view here to this import article. This import article will now import the articles and trim a lot of things and get counts and there is no kind of type hinting and anything, but you do here some counting and then you have a lot of properties and these properties are also never defined anywhere. It's also a big problem. The documentation of the CSV mobile.de is hard to read and so on. And you see here a lot of code for the things and the main thing that here makes a lot of problems is when a car is the first time on the internet and has no image, it only has an image where is a placeholder what has the same name as the image from the first real images. So you have to check if there are new first images, or even if there are more images than one images, and then you have to replace the first image. And when it's not having more images, then you keep this image. And this is also super hard stuff, and I'm avoid to make here changes because it is super hard to read and you do not actually know what you can break. It's running and you say it's running all my life, never touch it. But I must do updates for Symfony, for Sulu CMS, for new features, and also because I want to implement AI features just here with Symfony AI. So let's go to the terminal and see what we can do here. We can just say list here. If we have done anything with Claude, then we will have CloudMD and a .claude folder, and we want to make this plain here for this new project. So we say here Claude. And now you have here to trust the folder, and you can say, hey, this is a really good folder here, and everything works. And when you have this here, now you can make an init to create a CloudMD file and make some instructions for Claude. And this is an initial process. This would read some rule sets from me. It's also with some improvements, but SuperClaude is the best thing you can have. And now you have new commands like analyze. And when you just press analyze, you will have here a first touch with SuperClaude. And SuperClaude now will tell you that it will check the code and how it checks the code for security, for performance, for architecture, or just the code. And we only want to do this now just for the code and for the source folder. So here we have the problems, or maybe we can also directly go to the commands, but I think when we see anything what is in here, we have a better overview. And now it starts, and you need Claude Code Max for it because it's burning so much tokens and costs a bit of time. This will run now a few minutes, but here is an overview what it will do and what it will check. So you have on SuperClaude that you have to use dry principles and good naming and good structure. It checks for potential bugs, null checks, boundaries, types, security analysis, performance analysis, and now it's doing anything here what we need. So all files are checked. I will have this video now in real time. Yes, this will be a few minutes, but we will see what it definitely works and how fast it is and how the result is. And sometimes I will comment here some stuff. So a little time skipping, but now it finds out where here are the right files and all the services and controllers and more core files. And now you see here how many tokens it uses. So we have 20k of tokens on each kind of analyze for commands, services, controllers, and the core files. And here the core files need more than 1 minute of time. But now it's ready and will generate a comprehensive analyze report. And we have security issues, performance issues, code quality, 5 of 10 for a clean coder here on YouTube. It's super hard and it needs work, but the security issues are critical. The architecture is poor and there are some things that need immediately attention. So the CSV download command has critical security issues. The article import command has security and performance critical issues. The Twig app extension has XXS problems. Article import has SQL injection risk. This is super hard, but I never have done something for security. And maybe with SuperClaude, I can do a lot of more things for security. I will scroll up here a bit. And you will see that here is some other things what we can maybe handle easier than security problems. There are some performance problems, the code quality, missing import validation, inconsistent error handling, hard-coded configuration values, and so on and so on. So this is all done and we can say now, generate analyze.md file to go forward with simple tasks and after that generate a task.md file how to go forward with refactoring. Also think about adding tests to make clear actual state is running and future changes will run. This is an important thing that you go forward directly with PHP unit in this project because then you have a code base with testing and you can let Claude rerun the changes as many times as it needs to go back to a green state. I will show you this in the future. Now we will generate these two files, then we will look at it and go forward with this refactoring on the next video. So here is now the analyze.md file with a lot of examples and a lot of stuff. We will not look in detail what is made here because we will do this on the next video. And after that, we will now have a task.md file. What is maybe the file where we will define what is important and what not and how we go forward with this code optimization helped by AI tools like this Claude Code stuff here. And we will also use every time SuperClaude. Now here is this task.md file and here are examples what to do and we will check one of this create validation system. Here we have an import validator file and this import validator file will collect errors and this is a nice thing. So we will generate this now and then it will be finished for today. SuperClaude and Claude AI. I hope my tutorial videos will help you. Give comments and likes what I can improve, what you want to know and to see. This would be great and I can directly go forward with this. When you want more of this actually refactoring project in English, just comment. Otherwise, I think I can also switch to German to my community and it's like you want. Here are two videos that you like and then have a green day and nice time. Bye, ciao.